Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullah. My name is Sayyid Muhammad Al-Karbalai. I'm originally from Iraq, Karbala, and live in South London. I have to deliver message to remind the Shia the message of Imam Hussein. There is a message being narrated from Imam Hussein Katagala, Bibi Sakinane Rivayat Kiya. Shi'ati mahma sharibtum azba ma'in fadhkuru.
MashaAllah. And how are you going to impress the judges? How are you going to, you know, show them your talent and that you deserve to go through to the next round?
Wallahi, brother Sayyid Muhsin, I never think like this. All what I think, I'm here for barakat. I'm here to tell Imam Sahib al-Zaman, you have a small servant, humble here. That's all what I'm thinking about. So if I win, alhamdulillah. If not, all is for me is the intention. I'm not after riya or showing off. Even my voice let me down, even anything. Just saying Ya Hussein with pure niyat, this is my intention.
Very, very inspiring words, Sayyid Muhammad. Best of luck for the competition. Thank you.
Santum, jazakumullah khair. Santum.
Sayyid, you're gonna go on. How do you feel? Confident?
Of course, alhamdulillah, I'm confident.
We're gonna represent Abu Fadl Abbas, inshallah.
Inshallah. I'm taking my soul, my imagination in Bain al-Haramain.
Ya Allah, take your mind to Karbala.
Sayyid Muhammad al-Karbalai, how old are you?
43 years.
43, mashallah. What made you decide to enter the Shia voice? What was the reason you entered?
I never had the opportunity, to be honest. Alhamdulillah.
Amazing. And what would you recite for us?
This is opportunity for you.
This is the opportunity for you.
Don't say that.
If Sahib al-Asr al-Zaman accept me, the smallest khadim, inshallah.
What will you recite for us tonight?
Arabic and Urdu.
So a combination of Arabic and Urdu.
Inshallah. And this is because this is Shia voice. This is Shia voice. So I want to deliver or remind a Shia. I don't think any Shia when they drink water, don't say, Assalamu ala al-Husayn. Allahumma salli ala al-Husayn wa ahli bayti wa al-anqati.
MashaAllah. Go ahead.
I would say, I control my nerves and I was okay in the beginning on the stage. But once I started, believe me, I lost even the rhythm, the tune I prepared to recite the Qasida or Noha.
Shi'ati mahma sharibtum azba ma'in fadhkuruni. شيعتي مهما شربتم عذب ماء فاذكروني أو سمعتم بشهيد أو ذبيح فاندبوني شيعتي مهما شربتم عذب ماء فاذكروني أو سمعتم بغريب أو شهيد فاندبوني إيش يو جب بينا باني بلنا جانا مجي ذكر غربت يا شهادت هو ترو لنا مجي شيعتي مهما شربتم عذب ماء فاذكروني أو سمعتم بغريب أو شهيد فاندبوني فأنا السبط الذي من غير جرم.
When I was small, I used to gather my brothers, recite for Nadeem Sawar, recite for Hamza Zaghayr, Quran. I was, alhamdulillah, always used to be the first in Quran competition in the school, Saddam time. So, and being speaking Arabic and Urdu, I would like to bring both culture in Noha and khidmat Ahl al-Bayt. أو سمعتم بغريب أو شهيد فاندبوني دوستوں میں ہوں نواسا سید کون نتا دوستوں میں ہوں نواسا سید کون نکا جرم دائے اشقیا نے مجھ پر بے جرم خطا ليتكم في يوم عاشورا جميعا تنظروني all together ليتكم في يوم عاشورا جميعا تنظروني كيف استسقي لطفلي فأبوي يرحموني ليتكم في يوم عاشورا جميعا تنظروني كيف استسقي لطفلي فأبوا أن يرحموني صلوات
الله فاسك سيدنا احسنتم بارك الله فيكم
سيدنا you know as I said you know we are here to learn wallahi even I am learning in this program believe me yani our life is just to learn so I will go straight yeah
sure
you have problem on rhythm the rhythm wasn't correct you know some verses longer than other verses body language was weak okay and you didn't know how to control the mic. The good reciter knows how to control the mic. You were reciting for yourself. It looks like, put in your mind, there is mic and there's an audience. They are here. They want do sinazani, they want do latom. Work on yourself. Wallahi, work on yourself. Please.
I'm gonna go to say Maitan, please.
It's a very sensitive position to be a judge on this show. May Bibi Zahra, salamullah alayha, forgive me, but I have to be honest because there are people out there judging us as well. Make sure we don't do any injustice to anyone else who may be more deserving. You know, it's good that you came here because a lot of times if you're reciting in public, there's going to be judges there as well, but they'll never give you feedback. They'll decide something for themselves. They'll go back home. They've already have judged you. For me, you know, I felt that your voice was trembling a little. The notes, the higher notes, you were afraid to hit them. The rhythm was a little off. The pronunciation of Urdu was good. I think... there's some things you still need to work on, inshallah. We're all here for you, inshallah. And he's saying, every day I learn something new. And for us,
Yeah, I know what he's saying. Yeah, he's saying, I learn daily something new.
Oh,
yeah.
Alhamdulillah.
So I just wanted, on that point, I wanted to say that we don't consider ourselves experts either. Like Mullah Nizar said, we still consider ourselves talib-e-ilm. We're still learning daily.
So Jalal, I'm only going to go to you because of the technicalities of the sound. I know that you have something to say around this.
Okay, Sayed, thank you very much for your actually performance. First of all, you look younger, mashallah. You don't look like 43. So of course you look after yourself and that is the blessing of Ahlul Bayt. Another thing, can I ask you to recite again just the first part? Because I know that you had a fear and now a little bit the fear just gone. Just one short part, please.
Nade Ali ka wird jo karti chali gayi Umre raba suku se guzarti chali gayi Jisne dare Hussain pe sar ko jhuka diya Wo shakhsiyat jahan mein ubarti chali gayi دیوانے وار لوگ بھی مرتے چلے گئے تیغِ علی جدھر سے گزرتی چلی گئی مرحب ہوا میں مرحب ہوا میں اچھلا جو کا کر علی کی ضرب ہاتھوں سے تیغ و پیروں سے درتی چلی گئی.
I think if I were to... Sorry, I'm cutting you off. I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
Just don't try to go through it so fast. You know, take your time. Na de Ali ka virt jo karti chali gayi umre rawa sukoon se guzarti chali gayi.
Aap itna buzurg itna bara ustaz hai, aapse seekhte hain hum.
Hey Gerard, last couple of words, please.
Yes. You all saw the change. I think from if I wanted to give him, for example, I don't want to mention the number, for example, it should be double now because it completely changed. Why? Because, you know, I know that the stage takes... So, the clarity of voice. Now the voice actually is clearer. Drink plenty of water and warm up your voice. And another thing, yes, about tempo and timing. And engage a little bit with more actually audience. And don't go too much to high pitch. Thank you very much.
Dr. Said Ammar, your feedback, please.
You're one of these people who I would say is a jack of all trades. Master of, let's see which one.
So there's Arabic and there's the Urdu and
well,
there's
yeah, you know, I know him.
Yep.
And I've seen him. If you want du'a recited, he'll recite du'a. You want Quran recited, he'll recite Quran. You want poetry recited, he'll recite poetry. MashaAllah. And this is from his, you know, he is a very sincere individual. And I've seen his servitude, but he has to come to the conclusion. What are you going to be a master of? Mm. You know, there's some football players who have been amazing in terms of they could play right back, left back, center back, center mid, but you could never really remember their position by the end of their career.
Yeah.
And in this example, of course, cannot be related to the servitude of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because it's all amazing and it doesn't matter what people remember you for. But you yourself have to ask yourself a question now, and that is if you do get through to the next round, what are you going to be the master of? Is it Arabic or is it Urdu? Is it Noha or is it Qasida? Is it Dua? And that's what we're going to be looking for, inshallah.
Please, can I get a loud salawat ala Muhammadin wa Ali Muhammad for Sayyid Muhammad al-Musawi. Salawat.
This one time was Ramadan in a hot day. We're waiting for iftar. Was there?